Thank you for sharing your Wednesday night with me. This is AfroEconomics Live. Yes, indeed, we're talking about investment portfolios, specifically the AfroEconomics investment portfolios that I structured specifically for you. And to individualize your investment portfolios, I tried to structure so many investment portfolios that we're able to take care of different risk tolerance levels. And when you're working with JB Bryan Financial Group, my registered investment advisory firm, the home of AfroEconomics, one of our first steps when someone becomes a member, they become an investment client, or when they develop a relationship with the firm in any capacity for investment selection, we focus on getting in tune with you. So the investment risk tolerance, your risk level, is a big part of your investment policy. So I develop an investment policy statement from the information that you share with me. So that's why when I described tonight's discussion, I talked about the portfolios and I said, we're gonna talk about risk analysis and we're gonna talk about time horizon, because each of you could have similar risk levels. And thank you to those of you who participated and shared your risk analysis, because those of you who registered early, I sent out a risk questionnaire. If you would like to get your risk questionnaire so that I have your risk score so that we can talk about it, definitely make sure that you email me. Email me, JB@AfroEconomics, and I will get the questionnaire back to you. And in the questionnaire, I ask you things like, what's your investment goals? What's going on currently? What state of your life are you in? What's your birth date? How much money do you have to invest? You know, some things you would never think about, right? But I definitely ask about things to give me an idea of how much time you have for this money to grow for you. Like, how much time can you allow the money, this portion of your money? If you're not telling me about all of your portfolio, I'm asking you specifically about this portion. You might say, well, for this right now, I'm telling you the risk level for this 100,000 of my $1 million that I have to invest. Or you may say, I have $1 million. I want to know how to invest all of it. And then you answer the questions, your birth date, how much time you have between you and having to spend the money. Now, I asked a question of retirement because generally, people upon retirement are starting to use their money. So they want to start using their money to live off of. But you might not want to actually use this money upon your retirement, and good for you. But so if the question is, if you're in retirement and it's asking you when you're going to retire, then you need to really, we'll adjust that together, that because it may actually just be misleading to the computer that, yeah, I'm already retired. So you'd be like, tomorrow, or you're just about to, but you really still have a long time horizon for the money that you're investing. So look, doesn't that sound like probably what in the world? But the point is, I need to find out how much time you have for this money to grow for you. That's the bottom line. I want to know, how much time do we have for this? How much volatility? So then we take that next step and we take the money, the computer takes the money that you say you want to invest. And it says, if this money goes down this much and has the possibility of going up this much, are you comfortable with that risk level over this given period of time? And if you go, oh no, I don't care how much I could make, I can't stomach losing that, the possibility of losing that much, then you're moving towards having a lower risk tolerance. And couple that with, you're gonna retire within the next 5 years, literally. Like, you know, then your time horizon is shortened. So the algorithm is going to automatically give you a lower risk score. So I will match you with one of my portfolios that will have a risk level that are based on what's in it. So the risk level of an investment portfolio is based on what ingredients I put into that portfolio. So be mindful that this is a process. So you have to be very careful when you're just looking at something and you're talking about how great this particular investment performance has been, but you don't know anything about how that particular portfolio has performed over the short term, has performed over the long term. It might even be something brand new. It might even be, something that's totally not even real. So my job as your investment advisor is to help you look at long-term performance. We look at the ingredients in the portfolio, what's in there. Is it real estate? Is it real estate stocks? Is it, technology stocks? Is it international companies? You know, so my illustrations show you what's in it. So let's look a little farther. Hi, everybody. Thank you for logging in. If you have any questions for me as we move along, don't hesitate to do that. So we're talking about investment portfolios, my AfroEconomics investment portfolios, as well as the time, your particular time horizon and your risk tolerance level. So be mindful, how do I determine your risk tolerance level? Well, I want you to do a questionnaire I have that will allow technology to assist us in doing something that really needs personal attention. I don't believe that computers can replace me, but they can definitely assist me. And we want to maximize the utilization of technology assisting us in our investment process. So let's look, I'm going to share on the screen the risk analysis. I'm going to send you something that looks like that. And I hope that you can see. Can you see it? The risk analysis, it's going to give you, it's going to come from me. And then you're going to click to get started. And then you're going to answer the particular questions like many of you did last night. Thank you so much for doing that. You really did. So I get your score back and, just say, and I'm going to pull up the other that actually shares, I'm going to share with you just a snippet of the list of the investment portfolios that I've structured for you. So I'm going to tell you about our poll. We have a poll going on of your main financial goals. So of course, having money in cash is a risk level of 1, but just to say that your risk level comes in at a 45. So through our conversation, we have to decide if you want to move more towards the balanced, or if you want to move more toward, if you want to take your 45 and go down and lower your risk, or if you're saying, well, I'm not going to need it for the next 10, 20 years, and you want to move towards maybe a growth portfolio. So then I will show you my AfroEconomics growth portfolio that has a 63 based on the contents in it. So what changes that AfroEconomics balanced and the AfroEconomics growth? What? More long-term equity exposure. So you've got, a lot more equity exposure in your growth portfolio, meaning stock portfolio, where you're in a lot less of the fixed income bond exposure in the growth. So we might focus on what it has less of. So, and we have more bonds in the balanced portfolio. So then we would look farther and I would show you, possibly both and say this has this and you could do a combination. We don't have to do all or nothing. We could do 50% balanced portfolio, and then 50% the growth portfolio. We could do that as well. So if you wanted to get closer to a 45, we put that together, and then I could give you a different risk score based on our combined portfolios. And then, but some of you, like I had one I was working on today, and he had a 98. So he's going to fall in our AfroEconomics Warrior portfolio, but you might say, well, I know I said 98, but looking at the volatility, because I'm going to show him historically how much risk exposure in the Warrior, we're going to have some exposure to even individual stocks where I may have more some ETFs and so some combined portfolios. So the ETFs are exchange traded funds, but they don't have the loads of your well-known mutual funds that dominate, unfortunately, too. Many investors, they haven't looked at your ETFs as an option. And I'm allowing you to have exposure to things that have a lot lower expenses and fees to our community. Afroeconomic portfolios are a fantastic opportunity for you to reduce the fees. I've even been able to compare. I can compare your existing portfolio that you're doing and show you the fees and expenses associated and your existing risk level. So when I do the risk analysis, when you're looking at what you're currently doing and what you have decided where you want to be, the risk analysis is even more powerful because it allows you to say, whoa, I'm a 78 risk level and my portfolio is a 39. That means that you want more growth opportunities, but you don't even realize that you're not participating. And too many people are in that situation where they just select anything, especially in your work retirement plans. You know, now I see more and more of the work retirement plans are hiring advisors that are licensed like me, but they don't know anything about you. And we're signing up and paying them fees that they're not helping you at all. And I've caught it several times, and I'll tell the client, you don't need that. I don't understand what they think that they're doing for you, that you're going to pay a 1.5% fee just to get a statement. You know, so you have me. Your membership is to allow you to have the assistance of an investment advisor. And we just don't realize as AfroEconomics members the power that is at your fingertips. All you have to do is take advantage of this opportunity to empower your portfolio by allowing me to help you. Don't waste your time and your money. We cannot get our time back. So while you are in the accumulation phase of your life, we have to know these types of things. So these are my portfolios, but the majority of our community doesn't get exposure to these until they're leaving the job or are retiring and they're looking for other opportunities for them to do. And sometimes I'm doing my portfolios with a combination of some sort of, they might want some annuities, and I'm giving them the exposure to, you can have this growth, but you can also do some guaranteed products, but to combine them and to get you to your right and proper risk tolerance, meeting your time horizon, your goals, and making sure that you know where you are. So it's about getting to know where you are, what your goals are, what your risk level is, and what am I doing right now with my money? Very important. If we maximize our current blessings, our entire lifestyle can change just by maximizing what we have. Pretty much we think that money and making more money is a problem, but no, for many investors, and the majority of people I meet, unfortunately, it's that they are not maximizing the opportunities that they have because they don't have the access to a trustworthy person to assist them along. So we need to empower one another Share the information as much as we can. Help each other grow. That's what Afroeconomics is about. You know, don't just you do one thing, you participate in this webinar, and then you don't share it with someone else. So once we have this discussion tonight and you think this can help your grandma, you know, share it with her. Let her know about it. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much, Pastor Andrew. Definitely. Thank you. Thank you. I'm glad. He was expressing the importance of what we're talking about, indeed. So yes, indeed. Let's look at, so when I say the Afroeconomics 10, a risk score of 73, and that's a portfolio of my top 10, my top favorite, some large companies, some small companies, some mid-sized companies, and the risk score is still at a 73. Like, we think if we have, you know, individual stocks, that's going to be extremely risky. It really doesn't have to be. We just have to have a good understanding of, you know, what it is, you know, what the individual stocks are, which individual stocks that you put in there, and if they're relevant or if they're appropriate for your specific financial goals. That's what's most important. You know, not, oh, it's individual stocks. We're generalizing. We cannot afford to generalize. We have to continue to make sure that we grow in information. And my favorite, the Afroeconomics Sankofa Equity Fund, you know, 100% stock fund, but still not as aggressive as that Warrior portfolio. So definitely make sure that you understand that cash is a one. What does that mean? You can be, I think it's kind of misleading though to say that cash is a number one, because you also run the risk with cash, right? You run the risk of not having enough money in order to live the lifestyle that you want to have. So just because, you know, cash, oh, it's not risky, it doesn't really bring home the fact that you are also taking the risk, you know, of not growing your money, not outpacing the cost of living. Remember, we had the discussion about the time value of money. So that's why I encourage, like, this one, the 21 Afroeconomics Inflation Edge. I named it that because it's giving you some growth opportunity exposure, but you're also being, you know, really conservative. 21 out of 100? You know, so, you know, you're still down there, but you're giving yourself a slight inflation edge so that you can try to outpace inflation. That is even lower than my Afroeconomics conservative, going to have some more growth potential exposure. And then your balance portfolios are your combination. You're looking more like 50-50. Some, my balanced portfolio is more of a 50-50 blend of the, of your bonds, your fixed income, and your equity exposure. And the more we move to higher numbers, the less bond exposure we're including in there, unless it's high yield, like corporate bonds. But everyone is not comfortable, you know, with that. But that's what we have to, when we're talking, we're explaining all that, you know, that we're talking about that. I'm talking about all that. I'm explaining all of that to you, that, you know, these are the countries that you have exposure to. I also have the Afroeconomics Worldwide and for, you know, Afroeconomics Global Portfolio. Here we go. 71, we have additional international specific, you know, international exposure in there. So global means it's going to include the US as well. A pure international portfolio is not going to have the US in it. You know, where global means it can include exposure to this country. Well, and you gotta be careful, because I could say global, and you still don't, you cannot assume what it has in it. A title, we can set names and have names for our portfolios, but you have to find out what that means. You know, the Afroeconomics Warrior is not full of companies that fight, you know? So it's like, We have to be, you know, aware of what's in it. So when we do the analysis, I show you information or show you at minimum your top 10 exposures in the portfolio. So great. And then, so what your next step would be is to, you know, say, and I'm going to encourage you to check your email. And if you have the risk tolerance quiz in there, send it to me. It will send me a copy back. And then we can discuss that. And then the AfroEconomics team will call you and say, do you want to talk to JB about your risk level that you just, your risk score, your risk analysis that you just completed for me? We'll set up a time for us to talk about it. Then we can see about how that can help you, not with just my portfolios, but it's about how we can bring that into your current portfolio that you have and that you can take it seriously. Because I have a full database. I can pull in your current portfolio and tell you what that score is of what you're currently doing and tell you how we need, what we need to adjust given the options that you have, what we need to adjust for that. So we're talking about some key advantages for AfroEconomics membership that every member, I hope that you are definitely taking full advantage of. I'm going to continue this type of discussions in the AfroEconomics Business Summit in New York on September 22nd, all day Saturday. We're going to spend time together. I really want to focus on entrepreneurs, people who have their own business, who want to start their own business, who want to take their businesses to the next level, the 10 principles of AfroEconomics. You know, we're going to just break it down and make this a part of your business and personal financial life. So if you have any questions, don't hesitate. Know that I will give you this risk analysis. Member or not, I will allow you to do this risk analysis for yourself. To take it to the next level, though, I will need you to become a member so that I can totally assist you. Just because of regulation, I have to make sure that you know my responsibilities to you and that you sign off on the proper documents. Thank you. Thank you so much. I forgot. I had that up. Thank you so much. Mr. Benta says, switch back. I love y'all. Y'all are so good, Theo. Yes, indeed. Oh, that's right. All right. Well, you know what? To everybody out there on Facebook, while I am streaming, it is hard for me to see what you're saying. So we are definitely, and well, I shouldn't even say hard, impossible. We cannot see right now. So you, I really need you to make sure that you register at AfroEconomics.com so that you can, look, and I'm going to show you, like I'm going to pull it up and register, like right in. I want you to go down, it's my little square, and you go, when you go to this page, leave me a message. You can do that, or you can go into this green square. Look at the screen, it's over here, and it has a black, look, I'm gonna have to refresh the screen for it to pop up, but you can actually sign up for the emails. Ooh, there it goes. Sign up for email updates. Make sure you do that so that you can start participating in the webinar. And then I want to look at your poll that you all did. 27% of you said that your goal is starting a business. Participation tonight, y'all, is phenomenal. I thank God for you. That the starting a business, it just feels good to be able to feel that I'm impacting your life. You know, just know that that's my number one goal, to make sure that your life is enhanced from my presence. Starting a business, almost 30%. Make sure that you register for either the online access for the New York AfroEconomics Business Summit or, right, come in. Come on in. And it's absolutely free because even the people who pay that are not members are getting a membership for paying. So it covers your entire membership for the year. So get involved. Get involved in the Business Summit. Retirement, 9%. On Monday, I'm going to continue that discussion. I'm on CBS WTVR on Monday, and I'm talking about that. Like, we have 9% people said that their main financial goal is retirement planning. I appreciate that because I feel like we need to focus on financial independence today. So I am glad that twice as many, 18%, they're focusing on debt freedom. I love that because you get that free, you ain't have to worry about retirement, correct? 30%, 27% to be exact, said investment selection, 9% home ownership, 9% said budgeting, all of that. AfroEconomics membership, we can knock that out. But I am only as helpful to you as you allow me to be. I have found that the only time membership is not successful is when people do not take out time for themselves. Because you see, I am here. I'm here for you. We do Zoom meetings with people all over the planet. So if you don't have to be right in my backyard, even though I have 3 backyards, we got New York, we got DC, we got Virginia, you know, but you don't have to be there. We can be right here. We can be connected. We're on the telephone. You don't have to look at me, but you have to make that commitment to yourself. If you don't, then it's not going to happen. You know, that just not going to happen. You would take your financial life extremely seriously, but it goes over into every aspect. It really does. We start getting your other aspects of your life together, then all of a sudden you're going to be a better member of AfroEconomics. It's so true. It's a lot of times your money is a reflection of something else that's going on. So let's continue to talk on the Wednesdays and Fridays for our members only meetings and our Sundays. And let's just keep on going. But I think we should start. I would like each Monday at noon for me to start doing, you know, those Money Mondays and get on that. It's just that I'm fired up. And I keep forgetting. I get involved in my day and it's like, and I'm like, oh, I wanted to go say something. But once I like buckle down and I just say, hey, we're going to do that on Monday. So if that's something you really want to do, you know, let me know. I'm thinking of like midday. I'm midday. We're just going to dominate. Nothing changes unless we really become what some would call success, obsessed about your financial success. That ninth principle of AfroEconomics, right? Determination. We have to be determined to be financially independent. That second principle, self-reliance. So you all do what you gotta do for yourself. Thank you for the opportunity to serve you. And I'm only an email call away. My number 1-844-JB-Bryan or email jb@afroeconomics.com. Or go to the website and go down and click there as well and leave a message. And some of you do that. I think that's cute. I really appreciate it. Yes, indeed. Okay. Yes, indeed. Well, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for your comments. Thank you for your questions. Thank you for your encouragement. You all have a great one. And please share this video with your friends. I will be posting it on the YouTube channel. Oh, you are wonderful. Uh-huh.